Hello and welcome. So I'm doing another page out of seasons, and this page I've decided to do in monochromatic blues. So I'm using my masking fluid again with my ruling pen, and as I'm starting off here, I quickly find that I had my ruling pen a little too wide because that was allowing too much of the masking fluid to go onto the paper. So you can adjust the width, and the narrower you have the opening at the end, the least amount of masking fluid will come out. So it just takes a bit of adjustment to kind of get it right. And I will leave a link down below. My last video, I left the same link. It's a video about masking fluid that I found really helpful, how to apply it and tools that can be used to apply it. And so I decided to do it again for this page here because I will be doing a watercolor background with the same watercolors that I used in my last video. I'm really loving those Kuratake watercolors. They're just so beautiful. Their colors are so vibrant and really made a nice background. So I'm going to do it again for this page. There will be more voiceovers throughout the video explaining as I go along. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. All right, so now that the masking fluid has completely dried, I'm going to go ahead and get out my watercolors. And I first put a scrap piece of cardstock and also paper towel over the top of that behind my page that I'm working on. And this will help ensure that no paint soaks through to the page underneath. And I found that worked really well for absorbing any spillover paint. And I did get a little tiny bit of paint around the edges of the opposite side, but it wasn't really enough to bother me or worry about. And so I just kind of start applying the paint. I want the darkest colors kind of in the corners as well as the bottom of the page, and just kind of randomly dab colors. I listed the colors down below. I want the outer edges to be darker and kind of lighter towards the middle of the page. All right, so here I grabbed my Distress ink in Chipped Sapphire, and I decided I wanted the edges up top and along the side to be a little bit darker, but I didn't want to get my watercolors back out because I had already put them away while I was waiting for the page to dry. So I grabbed this Distress ink and just kind of inking up along the edges before I remove that masking fluid. Okay, so here I picked up my rubber cement pickup tool, and I just used that to pick up that masking fluid, and the key is to just take your time and go gently, you know, that way you don't risk tearing the page. I did have a couple areas where some of the paper lifted up a little bit, but it's really, you know, something that you can definitely work with. If it's just in a small area, it's really not going to affect the overall picture. And really the key is making sure that your masking fluid isn't too thick when you're laying it down onto the paper. You would just want a nice, light, even application. All right, so I finally got all that masking fluid off. And here is the previous page, and I just wanted to show you there was a tiny bit of spillover along the edges there, but there was no bleed through. And so there was just that little spot there, which I feel I could probably remove with just a tiny bit of water if I'm really careful. At least I could lighten it up anyway. So for me, that wasn't a big deal. So I will be using my Gamsol and an old paintbrush for blending for this page. If you prefer a different method of blending, by all means, use your preferred method. I just like this because it's quick and easy and it is less stress and work on my hands for blending. And I really like the results. This time I have poured a little bit of the Gamsol into my ceramic palette there and am working from that. Oh yeah, I forgot to add the Parma Violet before I blended. So I'm adding it now and then I'll just blend it again. But for the rest of these lily flowers, I will try to remember to add in the Parma Violet before I blend. All right, so as I'm applying this Stickles in Black Diamond, I'm just trying to keep it concentrated to the darkest area of the flower. All right, so this completes the video for this page. I hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll see you for the next video.